then it starts to balance out. But like, man, we're gonna be wearing a tiara at the end of the game. All right, go get him, buddy. Okay, now real quick. Break. I want to get that butt up. Bad attack. Boom. Bad attack. Boom. Shield. Boom. 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 There we go. There we go. Now I... Oh my god. Okay. Get. Okay. Shield up. Topple, buddy. Come on, topple. Topple. There you go. Okay, slow him down. Wait for the... Ooh! Oh, it looks so good. I looked at the Wii version. I also looked at the 3DS version. And this is...
Okay, it should work now.
Great. You saved my skin.
Also, I'm sorry. The buff boys are no longer the buff boys. They're still buff, but they're not the boys.
But it's out of ether.
Yeah.
Change the cylinder and it will be as good as new.
I think it's time for the introductions. I'm Ryan. He's Shulk.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, look, did you ever play the original, out of curiosity?
I'm Juju.
Juju?
Where are you two heading? If you've got time, you should come back to our camp.
Your camp?
Yeah. It's not far.
How about it?
You're the OG Wii one. Okay.
I'm surprised there's a HOMS camp here. But they might have some information.
I suppose.
Juju, can you tell us how to get there?
Sure. If you go back to the oasis, you should see a tall stone post. Head there first.
Then what?
There's a small path in the woods next to the stone post. Just follow it down to our camp.
Oh, there was no way I was going to find that.
Let's make a move.
No way. Remember being disappointed at first because I thought it was related to Xenogears? Oh. No, I can see that. Side note, love the name of this. Oh, that's a field pony. Where's the... yeah, there's the noise pony. Ponyo. I was doing a little bit of grinding last night, and I wanted an extra level and a half. So, it's... Yeah, the naming in this game is... Superb. And my understanding is Xenogears is more traditional turn-based JRPG. Very similar to, like, Final Fantasy. Which, down the road, if I can, because we got Death Stranding coming up, we have Assassin's Creed 2 coming up, Danganronpa V2, all of that, but, I'm going the right way, okay, yeah, down the road, I wanna, because we gotta finish up our, Lunar game, because otherwise, Mad might get mad at me. But, after that, I want to throw in Legend of Dragoon. Oh, a random dude? Just chilling out here. So I remember liking that as a kid, but I can't remember a damn thing about the story, the music, the gameplay. I just remember being like, I really like this. I have no idea why. But I really like that. Yeah. Oh, it's giant mech combat. Okay. Right down the road, actually take a look at Xenogears too. I'd love to actually take a look at Xenosaga because I remember I was so jazzed by that game. Like just the look and the feel of that game. And I remember playing the first game and then I got stuck and I never beat it.
Don't tell me you were...
Oh, shit, you.
I've told you a thousand times.
I swore my heart The Fiora.
But I thought...
Fiora.
Juju. Sorry.
Yeah, so...
I would be a lone bachelor for the rest of my life.
That gear. You must be survivors from the Defense Force. Is Colony 6 okay? Did Gaddo make it?
Hold on. What are you talking about?
We've come from Colony 9.
Colony 9?
They saved me from some monsters. This is Ryan and Shulk.
Oh, so you're not from Colony 6. Thank you for helping Juju. I'm his sister, Sharla.
I told them they could rest here, with us.
Did you now? Well, all right. I suppose that's only fair.
Did something happen to Colony 6?
Actually, we're heading there ourselves.
Colony 6 has been... our home.
Dominated.
It's been occupied by the Mekon.
It did not get to the chopper.
No.
Great game. Enjoy it. Though, if you're also looking for some fun, really can't be... I have the Grandia series. I played Grandia 2. I played 1. And did not even know until somebody in chat, like, a couple years ago, said, like, yeah, there's a third, too. What? Hey, can we have a heart-to-heart?
No!
I thought the fourth one was a spinoff. Also, there is one other series I do want to get down the road. It's called Dark Cloud 1 and 2. I remember having Dark Cloud 1. And then my best friend got super duper hooked into it. I mean, like, super hooked into it. And then Dark Cloud 2 came out. And... well, to be fair, I was busy with girls. I was busy with sports, so I didn't get around playing it. And my friend's like, dude, it's so good. He said they did everything better. I'm like, oh. Also, there's... it's weird. I hear... wait, is it going to start raining? It's going to have thunder. Which, by the way, this morning... yesterday, we had like... 80-ish, 85 degree weather, right? It was clear, and then all of a sudden, some point, like, during the afternoon, it just started to cloud up. And then all throughout the night and today, it's like 40 degrees outside right now. 40-ish, 44-ish. It's constantly raining. So, the immersion is very strong right now. Ah, that fresh rain smell.
Me.
Excuse me. Hey, you have a minute, donk. Do you know Bama? The Nopalm boy. He's been inconsolable ever since the day Colony 6 was attacked. See, he lost both his parents in the attack. So I want to do something for him. He really likes reading stories, and I want to give him a book. A creative skill is starting and at drawing and painting pictures. However, Ewan, who fled here with us... is a fantastic storyteller. Think of asking him to write the book for me, but it's not that easy for me to ask him myself. That does sound good. That doesn't sound good. I think we should get this sorted out as soon as possible. Yeah, let's do it. I just want everyone to feel a little better, you know. Although cheering Ewan up is going to be a lot more difficult. I won't lie by saying I understand what the kid's going through, but it just ain't right when a little kid is as sad as he is. Mm-hmm. And you're looking at the best people for the job. We've all people know what it's like to have a home demolished. So you'll talk to Ewan for me? Please take your time, don't rush. Okay. Yeah. Let me help out here. Love Dark Cloud as well. I was watching Loco talk about it and I was like, man, that actually sounds kind of fun. And I remember bits and pieces of like, you have to go around like this. The towns had gotten like sucked up by some magical sucking vacuum thingy, and every time you go back you can like somehow put them in your pocket, and then it's like a bag of infinite holding, and then you pull it out and you start placing it down like a jigsaw, so you build your own town. And yeah, those kind of sound kind of cool. So get a new PS2, some mini old Yeah. I was kind of hoping, because we're getting information about the new PS5 coming up here soon, right? Boy, I was kind of... Sooner or later, there's going to be a console. It's going to be like, yeah, we'll support all, like, disc versions of games, right? From, like, PlayStation 1, Xbox, all the way up to whatever latest disc verse there is. That'll be the console that'll win the wars. And yes, you could say, like, yeah, totally, PC's that thing, don't you understand? Yeah, but emulation can be tricky. Like, I've been keeping an eye on, the PS3 emulation. And it's all over the place. All right, let me go ahead and...
Me.
God, it's been a while since we actually traded for anybody. Oh, you got smelly hide. Don't worry, I got smelly hide too. Oh, wait, hang on. Olga.
Well?
Trade. Field gloves. Okay. Either up. Oh yeah, I got her. I got sugar. Don't worry. Well, actually, ooh, God. Night tulip. Let's see here. Dance apple, probably good at. Ooh, moonflower. Yeah, let's go with the moonflower. And trade. Okay. And. Oh, excuse me, miss. I would like another trade, please. I love the trading in this game. Like, I yep. Like, I'm in it to win it. DC1 and 2 are both only $10 a piece on PlayStation Network. Wow. Yeah, I actually already have them. But thank you, Willow. Yeah. No, again, I was listening to Loco talk about it. It's like, yeah, that sounds pretty good. So I could buy it. Infantry boots. We'll go ahead and buy those. Whoa, intermediate allows Sharla to learn further levels. Who is Sharla? Well, Sharla, you can cure. Let's go. I want Sharla now, chat. There's no way for me to, like... There's got to be a way to pull out. Those gems, because I want to keep those ether gems, but I don't know if it's possible to pull them out. Because I'm not seeing, like, an option to remove gem. Yeah. Like, I can swap it. But I'm not seeing a empty, right? Nice. I was hoping PS5 would be the one to allow all display all the way back to PS1. They rumored it for a while, but yeah, no, they did. They kept talking about it, saying that they were working on brand new compatibility tech. Were they really only talking about PS4? My understanding, though, is it's the PS5 is actually emulating the PS4. And if that's even remotely true, that means that the PS5 is probably just dumping as much power to push the emulation, right? So, yeah. The Monado. I should probably upgrade this. I completely forgot about upgrading that. Not bad. Let's see here. I'm gonna get engage up to max. That way we can. Well, higher topple might not be that bad of an idea too, because that'll increase what they can do. Knock on wood. But yeah, side note, I didn't know about the skill link thing because they didn't mention it at all while we were playing this. It popped up as a tutorial, but it was a tutorial that did not pop up. Like, it didn't pop up on the screen saying, hey, this is a skill link. It talked about skill branches, said nothing about skill links, and then at a later time, I guess it popped up and you had to dig for it. So, like, really? Should've popped up. Should've popped up, shit. Should've popped up. Should've, would've, could've. Should've, would've, could've. Really want to play Breath of Fire 3 and 4. I love those games so much and have the disc still. Breath of Fire. I hear those are actually pretty good. I've never played them. Army pick. Pike. It's really good. That's like really good. Oh god, he's like super picky. Super picky. All right, fine. I will give you a good one, old timer, because.
Hello there.
Says well to square things up. Oh. Pike on pike. It's not gonna be special, but it is gonna be leagues better. The question is, what does it look like? Army pike. Oh, well, never mind. Okay. Steady helm? Middle helm? Oh, yeah, that actually looks pretty... That looks a lot better on him. Ooh, that looks better. Nope. I love this appearance system, by the way. Like, oh! So good.
How's it going?
You want to make a picture book for Pama. And you want me to write the story for it. What makes you think I'd want to get involved in any of that? Not an author anymore. No, I'm nothing. I decided that I'm never writing ever again. You don't give up, do you? I'll tell you what. If you want me to do this, I'll need something first. I need some ponyo neck meat. The liquid collected from that meat makes the finest ink. You'll never find anything, though. Just go. You try. Don't come back crying when you get a kick in the backside. Thur, you're just like...
How's it going?
He's a salty asshole is what he is. Mm-hmm. Frankabut.
Greetings?
Sour gooseberries? Hold on, how many sour gooseberries do I... How many... Greetings? Look, I got one sour gooseberry. I will give you... a rest of boat for your sour gooseberry. Boom. Fair trade. That's how I up. Oh, so Sharla is a character we're gonna get.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I can work with that. 1 and 2 were on the SNES and were ridiculously grindy. 3 and 4 were on the PS1. They were both video game gems. Dragon Quarter was on the GameCube and it was awful. So bad it killed the series. Ouch. Ouch. Okay. Our home, Colony 6, was attacked by the Mekon. Listen to what I have to say? Yeah.
We had already fought off the Mekon a year ago. At the Battle of Sword Valley. It left us with a false sense of security.
Side note, I've noticed that normally... I don't talk to every NPC in a town, right? If you guys have seen me play video games and JRPGs, that's not really something I do. However, when you put a trade option with the potential to have like legendary or epic gear, I'm gonna talk to everyone that has a named name. So kudos to the devs for like literally breaking a habit that I've had for like decades. So, yeah. Yeah. Kudos. Also, some of the quests are pretty good. So, yeah. Generic fetch quests, but yeah. Super modern. Breath of Wild, it's because the main character is a little dragon. Ooh.
The Colony 6 Defense Force didn't even notice the approaching Mekon. By the time the air raid siren sounded, a swarm of Mekon had blackened the sky. They ate people and burned our buildings.
Are you using DisplayPort? Penny? DisplayPort? What? Super, what do you mean? Are you talking about for the Switch? A DisplayPort cable. For the Switch. No, one is an HDMI. And one is a DVI. So, I did actually have one for a DisplayPort cable, yes. Because my video card had 3 HDMIs. No, it had 1 HDMI, 3 display ports, and 1 DVI. So when you said display port, I was like, trying to figure out like what you meant by that, because that technically could be anything. Yeah, one of them had a display port, which, by the way, they can be a little finicky. Even if you plug it in, occasionally it will not pick up automatically, if you were wondering.
Me and Juju dedicated ourselves to evacuating the children and elderly.
Also, they don't feel like they lock in secure enough for my taste, compared to like an HDMI.
I don't know what happened next.
Oh, wow.
It's just like what happened to Colony 9.
They attacked your colony as well.
Yes. It's good that you managed to evacuate so many.
We have a Tharon, the Colonel, to thank for that. Him.
That sounds more like a faulty display port cable. Because when I had mine over here, when I first plugged it in, it had issues, and then I had to plug it in, pull it out, and then plug it back in. And then after a while, about, 5 or 10 minutes, it was fine. From the internet, this is normal for display ports. Really? And it's not a faulty cable. Huh. It could be like I said, they don't feel like they're secure when you put them in. So it could be a contact issue. Wouldn't be surprised.
And Gaddo.
This Gaddo.
He would have been my husband by now if not for all this. Cheer up, you two. We can't lose hope just yet. I'm certain Gaddo and the other soldiers are alive. They're still fighting. I can feel it.
You're on your way to Colony 6, right?
You bet. We're up for some revenge. I bet we can even get your colony back.
There you go, showing off again.
We're up some revenge! Justice!
If anyone can do it, it's you two.
The power of friendship!
Could you take me with you to the colony?
Juju, the people here need us. How many times do I have to tell you?
But you heard, the Mekon attacked Colony 9. That means a load of them have left Colony 6 already. It has to.
Even if that's true. No, especially if it's true. We cannot expose the camp to any more danger.
So, you don't care what happens to the people in the colony? How can you be so heartless? Are you that scared of the Mekon?
Check the future, see how bad this can get. Bad, really bad.
Oi, kid.
Ryan!
You ought to know how Sharla feels. Watch your mouth and have some respect.
I'll go and make dinner.
Okay, so please don't tell me generic boy is gonna go off and do generic dumb thing. And then we'll have to fight.
Maybe I was too hard.
Boss, generically.
Shulk?
Ryan.
Okay.
Of Gaddo when you get angry.
Hell.
I do.
Gaddo's taken care of us ever since we were young. I always saw him as a big brother, really. But he was more of a father to Juju. He'd call him kid whenever he told him off, just like you did.
I don't think I'm ready to be someone's old man just yet. Wait, Shulk. Did it happen again?
Yeah.
You had another vision. Oh, no.
No. Juju!
Bad Juju! Bad!
The buggy's gone! He's going to Colony 6 on his own!
Stupid kid!
We have to hurry. Something bad's gonna happen.
What did you see?
A deep valley. Everything's engulfed in flames. There's a black shadow. It kills Juju.
Is it the Mekon with the metal face?
Yeah.
Where does it happen? Is it near Colony 6?
I'm not sure. I think so.
Let's get after him, Shulk.
Hold on a second. What was all that about?
I know you won't believe this, but Shulk can see the future.
The future? That's not possible.
That's what I thought too.
Firefox.
I still can't explain this.
Utilizes less bandwidth.
Will come true unless we stop it.
So you're telling
also
me
GPU and CPU.
Believe it or don't believe it, that's your call. But I wouldn't be standing here if it weren't for Shulk's visions.
Side note, Chrome actually uses so much at a time, because over time, what ends up happening is it just gets bigger as you leave the browser open. And so when I used to stream with a single PC, I would see like drops in frame rates with the game, and then I would see like losses in OBS. And for the longest time, we had no idea. Like, I thought it was a hardware issue or a software issue. Technically, it was a software issue. It was just the thing I was not aware of. So, yeah. Chrome actually, it does have its effect. Like, it does have its perks. Sometimes it's much faster to get to certain pages. However, you're going to be seeing some weird things with your CPU and GPU. So just keep that in mind. If you're like my buddy who has like 50 tabs open, man can't close a goddamn tab, and I don't know why. Yeah.
Juju.
Also, real quick. To Windows, Microsoft, thank you for allowing the blue screen of death to happen yesterday after you updated, forcefully, might I add, your brand new updates.